So, you have the Hero 10, and maybe you're contemplating on whether you need the Media Mod or not. And just so you know, right now, I am using my favorite setup, which is the GoPro built-in microphones and the $5 Windslayer. So, yeah, that's all I use. But let's see what difference the Media Mod will make and see if it's even worth it.
Mr. Black.
Welcome to the channel. My name is Danny Black, and don't be a stranger. Links and info to everything will be down in the description, plus a surprise link. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and get right into it. There are two reasons why you might want this Media Mod. The main one is if you're looking to add an external microphone to your GoPro, or if you want to view it via HDMI out. So let's set aside the HDMI thing for now, and let's just focus on the microphone input. Now, if you already have one of these 3.5 millimeter adapters from a previous GoPro, well, I recommend keeping it and getting a housing like this that you could put it inside and set up your microphone, and there you have it, you're ready to roll. So let's just go out and do a simple test between the GoPro with its onboard microphones, the Windslayer, the Media Mod, and then adding extra microphones on so that you can hear the difference. All right, so this is what it sounds like. This is the GoPro with no microphones, like the inboard microphones, and the wind reduction is on auto, but you can hear what it sounds like. As far as like, you know, a vlogging, I'm holding this out just arm's length. I could put it a little bit further with the selfie stick, so you get it something like that. So maybe I need to speak up a little bit more, but now you can at least hear what it sounds like, and let's go ahead and put that Windslayer on. Okay, so this is what it sounds like with the Windslayer on, but also you have to know that you gotta put the wind reduction off, like turn the wind reduction completely off, and that also helps create like a much better stereo sound, but what the Windslayer does is it blocks all of the wind from all the directions, and this is probably the best thing. I use this thing constantly for recording just because it sounds great, especially for vlogging. So there we go. Let's go ahead and put the Media Mod on and hear what that sounds like. All right, so now this is with the Media Mod on the GoPro with the front facing microphone, which is right there. The best part about the Media Mod being on there is on the backside, you can see the meters going so that you know that the audio is coming through. That gives you a lot better peace of mind. But this is what it sounds like, so you can have a nice comparison. I'm not a big fan of the microphone that's built in. There is a sound muff on there. If I take the sound muff off, this is what it sounds like with it off. So obviously this sound muff is good. I keep saying the word muff, I don't know why, but it's good for blocking that wind, but it also just makes it very, very interesting sound. I'm not a big fan of it. But you know what? The reason why you'd want the Media Mod is for an external microphone, so let's hear what it sounds like with an external microphone. All right, so as you can see, I have the Video Micro, which is like the staple of little portable microphone systems, and it's connected to the Media Mod. You do see it, it's on the side of the GoPro instead of the top, and it's because, I mean, even here, you can still kind of see that dead cat kind of popping in. So it's kind of a big dead cat, but when it's on top, it definitely pops in a little bit more. So I like to set it to the side, but here's what it sounds like so you know the difference when you add that extra microphone. Now, to me, the Video Micro is pretty good, but I actually prefer the Telesyn. So I just want to show you the difference between the Telesyn, which is a cheaper price. So check this out. So now I'm using the Telesyn microphone so you can hear the difference between the Micro and the Telesyn. So you've got to work that dead cat a little bit. It's a bit tricky to kind of get that out of the shot. They do come with a foam cover, and I actually just forgot that one, but the dead cat is the best one as far as trying to get rid of any of that wind noise. Right now there's a lot of wind noise happening. If I was to take this thing off, you would hear how much wind is coming through. Actually, let me just show you. So right now this is the Media Mod microphone with no wind protector, so you can kind of hear how much wind is coming through. So let's plug this microphone on. So now you can hear the difference, like the wind is not as harsh with the microphone plugged in. So that's a huge benefit to having the Media Mod plus a microphone, but the Windslayer also does a great job with that. But for me, I actually think the best part about having a Media Mod for your GoPro is having a wireless microphone system. So let's go ahead and test that out. But one of the benefits of having a wireless system is to be able to be heard from far away. And that is one of the best things about this, and that's one of the best things about having Lensgo. Cheers. So now that you've heard the difference, you can decide for yourself. But what I recommend is if you're gonna be just talking to your GoPro, like vlogging style up close anyways, I just think that the $5 Windslayer will do the best job for you. It's a lot cheaper and there's less risk of screwing it up. Plus you also get the stereo sound and kind of capture the environment of where you're at as well, so it's kind of nice. However, with the Media Mod and the Rode Video Micro, it did a great job. It sounded fantastic, but that's also $150 more. So if you are looking to up your production values, then I guess, yeah, it would be worth the investment, either going with a Rode Video Micro or maybe just a Telesyn microphone, which is half the price. But for me, I do love the Linsgo 348C, and I think a wireless microphone like that would be the best overall so that you don't have to worry about pointing the microphone at you if you're talking and turning the camera around or whatever. But hey, I'm not trying to talk you into buying anything. If anything, I'm trying to help you save some money. And I just wanted you to be able to hear all of it in its raw format before you make your decision. So that's it for me today. I hope this helped. Thank you so much for watching, and do check out some of the other GoPro videos that I have. Also, check out all the other stuff that's on the screen right now, and I'll see you guys on the next one. See ya.
Mr. Black.